Hello guys, welcome to another video in the series. Today we are going to solve a problem which is called merge case sorted list. So you have to merge case sorted linked list and you have to return it as one sorted list. For example, these are the three linked lists that are given to you. You have to arrange them in the ascending order and you have to return finally one linked list. Let's see how to solve this problem. So let's take a simpler version of this problem, which is actually famous, right? There's a simpler version where let's say you simply have two linked lists, right? You simply have two linked lists, and in that case, you are trying to find out how to sort these two together and merge them together and return one singly linked list, right? So how do you solve that problem? So to solve that problem, basically what you do is you take two pointers, right? And then you keep comparing the values at these two pointers. For example, here you compare 1 and 2. So initially you place 1 because 1 is less than 2, right? And then you move this pointer forward. So you move this pointer forward. Now you compare 3 and 2. So in this case, which is smaller? 2 is smaller than 3. So you push 2 and then you go to the next element in this particular iteration, right? In this particular linked list. Now you have 3 and 4. So 3 and 4, among 3 and 4, 3 is smaller than 4. So we push 3 and then we go to the next element. So now when we are at the next element, what will we compare? We'll compare 4 and 5. Now in this case, 4 is smaller than 5, so you put 4. Okay, now we go to the next element here. So next we have 7 and we have, what do we have? We have 7 and 5. So now we'll compare 7 and 5, which is smaller, 5 is smaller. So we just put 5 and then we go to the next element, which is not existing, it is null. Okay, so we have nothing to compare. We'll just push 7. So we have solved the problem. Okay, so merging two linked lists is very easy, right? Just keep two pointers and then keep iterating over them because these two are anyway sorted. So you can just move to the next element in both of them. But now here the problem is there are k linked lists that are given to you, right? You don't have simply two pointers. Okay, even if there were suppose three linked lists given to you, you could have solved the problem, right? You could have kept three pointers, but we don't know what is the value of k, right? K can be anything, 10, 100, 10,000. So you don't know how many linked lists are given to you, right? So in this case, you don't know how many pointers you can keep. So you have to use some other data structure to keep those pointers. Once we get the pointers, there'll be so many pointers and you cannot simply compare each pointer with every other pointer, right? So you'll have to use some data structure. Okay, so how to do this for k linked list? So to solve this problem for k linked list, one simple approach is to use the data structure which is priority queue. Priority queue is the data structure which is nothing but a min heap data structure. Okay, let's see how that will be helpful. So let's say you have these particular linked lists, right? Let's say you have 1, 3, 5, 8, something like this. Okay, and let's say you have another linked list, let's say 2, 6, 7, and let's say you have another linked list, okay, 3, 5. Okay. So these are the linked lists that you have. They can have different sizes. Okay. So in this particular case, what are you going to do? You are going to make a min heap. So you are going to place the first nodes in our min heap, right? So which are the nodes that we have? We have 1, 2, and 3. So what we are going to do? We are going to make a min heap and we are going to store these particular nodes in our min heap data structure. Okay. So this is our min heap that we have formed with the first nodes, right? And now we are also going to get the smallest element. How will you get the smallest element? So usually you would have taken pointers and you would have compared, but in this case, easily if you use a min heap data structure, you can simply get the first element or the smallest element by just looking at the value which is at the top, because a min heap will store the topmost value, smallest by default. So we have got the value 1. Okay? So once you have got the value 1, what will you do? You will go forward in this particular linked list, right? So you will go forward in this particular linked list so that next time you can compare 3. So now you need to remove 1 and you need to put this 3 in the linked list. So that's what we'll do. So now our min heap will rearrange itself. What will it become? It will become 2, then 3, and then 3. So now these are the elements which you are basically comparing, 2 and 3 and 3. How will you get the smallest element? Just look at the topmost element of the priority queue, it is 2. Okay. So now you have got 2. So what you will do? You will move forward in the particular linked list because you have already got 2. You have already placed 2 in your linked list. So now you will go to the next element, which is 6. So now your min heap will also change, right? Min heap will have what elements? 3 and 6 and 3. Okay, so let me just quickly draw that min heap. So we have 3 at the top and then you have 3 and then you have 6. Okay, so this is your min heap. Now again the topmost element is 3. Okay, so you can take any of the 3. So let's say we are taking this particular 3. So we'll move forward here. And now the next element that we have is 5. Right? Next element we have is 5. So in this particular case, what will you compare? You will compare 3 and 6 and 5. Okay, so first what you are going to do is you are going to compare 3 and 6 and 5, but you are going to change it in the min heap, right? So you will have to change it in the min heap. So what will your min heap be? Your min heap will currently be consisting of elements 3 and 5 and 6. So the topmost element is 3, okay? So you will remove the topmost element 3 and then you will move forward in this particular linked list. So now you have these three elements, 5 and 6 and 5. So let me quickly draw the min heap again. So what will your min heap become? Your min heap will have elements 5 and 5 and 6. Which is the topmost element? Topmost element is 5. So we'll extract 5 and then we'll replace the min heap. So you have extracted 5. Let's say you have extracted this particular 5. So we have moved forward here, which is 8. Okay. So you'll have 5, you will have 6, you will have 8 in the min heap. So in this particular case, which is the smallest element? Topmost element, which is nothing but 5 again. So now your min heap is going to change again, right? So what is your, going to be your min heap? Your min heap is going to be only of element 6 and 8. Why? Because this 5 doesn't have any element after it, right? You have extracted it, it is null. You don't want to push null. So you will just have element 6 and 8 remaining. So now you will compare 6 and 8, which is smallest, 6 is smallest. So you will change your min heap, right? So what is your min heap? You have extracted 6, you will go forward, you have 7 and 8, okay? So you would have next time, you will push 7, so you have 7 and 8, which is the topmost element 7, and after you have extracted 7, you are just left with 8 as your min heap, and then you will go forward, you will extract 8. So you have got the linked list in sorted order. This is what we want and this is what we are going to return. So let us quickly code this. So we are going to first of all take a priority queue, which is a min heap data structure that we need, and it will need to store our nodes, right? And then the default syntax, you will also have to give a vector here, vector star. And now you have to sort, right? You will always have to have the min heap, okay, such that it stores the smallest elements, right? So our priority queue is a max heap by default, okay? But how do you sort a linked list, right? So you will have to give, how do you sort it? You have to sort it by values and you have to make it a min heap, right? So you have to give that. So you will have to declare a comparator function which is going to tell your priority queue how exactly you want it to store elements. So it's going to sort it in ascending order, okay? So by default it is a max heap, but we have to change it to min heap. So we'll give this my comparator. So let's see what is my comparator. So let's make it a struct, and then we will have to give bool operator, and we will have to give, let's say we have two nodes, right? How are you going to compare them? So if you have two nodes, then what are you going to do? You are going to basically see, get the value. Suppose you have two nodes like this, right? Let's say this is the first linked list that you have, which is something like this, 3, 5, 7. Let's say this is the second linked list, which you have something 6, 8, 10, okay? So what do you have here? Now you have 3 and you have 6, right? These are the nodes that you have. Let's say A is 3 and B is 6. So what are you going to do? How are you going to compare? You are just going to compare the values of 3 and 6, right? So you just compare the values. So return A val greater than B val. So why am I giving greater than? Because it's a max heap by default, right? So you have to reverse the sign and give it, right? So that's why it will get sorted and become a min heap. So you have to reverse the particular sign and give it. So this is how you are going to compare. And now we will go forward. So once we have made the, we have given the comparator function, we have made a priority queue, now we have to push elements in priority queue. So you can give for list node star x in A. So we are going to basically take all the list node that we have in our vector A, right? So our vector A has how many linked lists, we don't know, some k linked list it has. So we have to take all those k linked lists and then we have to just store them in our priority queue. So we have to push them in our priority queue. So it has become caps, let me change it. So we are going to push the head of these, right? We are going to push the node of these linked lists, right, in the priority queue. Now we have to do this only if it is not null, right? Because we have to be careful, they may give test cases where it is null. So in that case, you don't have to push it, right? Now this is done. Now we have a priority queue which has the elements. Now we have to start seeing the elements and then making our linked list. So now we have to return a linked list, right? So we are asked to return this particular linked list. So let me take that and let's give it a head, let's give it a tail, and initially let's make them null. Initially, they are null. Both of them are null. And finally, we'll return the head of our linked list. So now let us start iterating. So we'll iterate while the priority queue is not empty. Okay, once the priority queue becomes empty, we have inserted all the elements in our head. So that's what we are going to do. So first of all, we will see. Okay, first of all, we will take the topmost element. So let us take the topmost element. So how will we get the topmost element? We'll just give the syntax pq dot. Once we have got the topmost element, can we just pop it? We can pop it, right? Because we have to remove elements and we have to make the priority queue empty at last. That is our, that is what we want. So we have got our node that we have. Now this is the smallest value because we have sorted the priority queue according to how we wanted, right? We have sorted it. So now this is the smallest value, so you are going to insert it in the linked list. But first you will have to check if this is, if do you have to insert it at the end or at the beginning. For example, if the list is now null, you cannot just insert our linked list behind a null element, right? So you will have to check if your head is null. If your head is null, in this case, what will you do? You will make head is equal to x and you will make tail is equal to x. Okay, this is what. Okay. Now, this was the case when your head is null. If your head is not null, in that case, what will you do? If your head is not null, that means your head already has some value. Okay, let's say your head is already a linked list. Let's say it's having value 3. Now you have to insert it behind this, right? So let's say you have a new linked list that you are going to insert it now. So you are, let's say you are inserting 5 behind 3. So you already have, okay, this, you already have an element, you have to just insert it behind. So what will you do? Your tail will basically iterate and your tail will keep moving forward. Okay? And head will remain as such because we are going to return head. So we have the tail to move along the entire linked list. So we are going to just insert it behind our linked list. So what are we going to do? So we give tails next is basically going to be our x. And what is going to be our tail? Our tail is going to be equal to next for the x for the next iteration. So what we have done, we have suppose we didn't have the element 5, so behind 3 we are just pushing 5, right? So once we have pushed 5, next time the tail should become equal to 5, so that next time when we want to push the element, we will push the element behind this. Okay, so that's what we are giving. Okay, so this is fine. So this is fine till we are inserting the element. But now we simply don't want to just insert x. What do we want to do? We want to move it to the next element also, right? Next time we will insert the next element which is behind x. So this is where we have to take care. So now if x is having a next element, if it is not null, right? Then you will also have to push it in the priority queue. So we will push that in the priority queue. And once that is pushed in the priority queue, then you can go forward, right? So you can go forward because the next element of x is pushed in the priority queue. So in this case, next time the smallest element among those elements present will be extracted and this case will continue. So this is done and now you can return head. Let me test and see if this is working. Two or more data types declared. Let me see what is the problem here. Okay, I have to give a comma there. That was a problem. Let me test and see. PQ was not declared in this code. Okay. I have to give the name PQ. Let's test and see again. Okay, I have given PQ here, which is really sad because I should have given X. So if X is not null, then we are going to push the element. By mistake, we have PQ that. Let us just test and see again if it's working. Okay, there is some error with this code. Let us see what could be the error. Let me just give head is equal to t. See, it is fine. Yeah, it's working fine now. Okay, so that was the error. So basically our head should actually point to tail, so that as tail keeps moving. So let me submit and see if it's working. So it's working fine. That's it. Thank you for being patient and listening.